Hidden features! Aha! Here are 5 features that you might not know about in Midjourney. Number 1 is you can export beautiful progress videos from Midjourney, so you can see how it has generated the image that you're creating just like this. All you have to do is add in the command video, which is --video. So you can just put in warrior princess --video. And then once that is generated, to receive the video, you have to reply to the message with an emoji. And all you have to do is go up to the top right hand side of the message, click on add reaction, and then search for envelope, because it probably won't be there the first time you look for it. And it's this first basic envelope like this. And then you tap on this, and when the image is ready, it will process a video for you. So we sit here and wait patiently. Ha 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 ha, life is good, life is fun. La dee dee, let's have some coffee. Oh, too many coffees today. There we have it. And the way to get the video is to come up to the right hand side of the message, tap on add reaction, and then search for the envelope emoji. And then it looks like this. Once you've found that, tap on it, and it will export the concept as a generated video, as well as exporting each of the options that you have. A couple of notes here is that it doesn't work for upscales yet, so that feature is probably coming soon. Then we can look at this video of this one, and you have this pretty cool generation. There are a couple of other features that can be triggered using emojis. One is deleting an image from the Discord server. This is perfect if you want to keep some of your work private and stop other people from stealing it. All you have to do is go to add reaction, search, and then makes you find the cross. And then you tap that and it will delete it completely. Once you've used these emojis a couple of times, they will show up in your most frequently used so you can access them quickly. Another handy feature you might not know about is pulling up the settings in the chat. All you have to do is type in the command /settings, and you'll be able to change the algorithm that MJ is using. You'll be able to change how much stylizing gets inputted, and you'll be able to choose what is the quality of the output. Now this is really interesting because you can speed it up or you can slow it down, and this means that you're spending more or less on the generation of your images. There's also the relax mode and the private mode, which is a premium feature which stops other people from seeing any of your images at all. Another cool feature in Midjourney is that you can upload an image directly into the chats and use that as a prompt for Midjourney to create images from. So to do that, all you have to do is come to the plus in the message box, go to upload file, select any image from your computer, make sure it's less than 8 MB in size, and upload it. Once it's uploaded, you can tap on the message and then make sure to open it in a new tab. From here, we'll select the URL of the image, go back to the Midjourney bot, type in our command, imagine, and paste in the URL. And now Midjourney will create some images based on this uploaded photograph. Another cool feature is that you can tell Midjourney not to put some sort of element inside of an image. For example, if we go command imagine, and then we put man with dog, then we can put the command no and something else in. We can put no eyes. And then we have it. There is a man with a dog, and it has avoided as much as possible putting eyes into the image. There are 5 useful features that you might enjoy using on Midjourney. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, why not stick around and have a delightful day.